हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर ज्योति शिवाजी राव फ्रॉम एचएम कॉलेज कराड। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल सी डेटा टाइप्स इन एसक्यूएल। लेट्स सी व्हाट इज मीनिंग ऑफ डेटा टाइप। डेटा टाइप आर द टाइप ऑफ डेटा व्हिच आर स्टोर्ड इन वेरिएबल व्हाइल स्टोरिंग डेटा इनटू द डेटाबेस। देयर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डेटा टाइप्स व्हिच आर यूज्ड इन एसक्यूएल। The first data type is character data type. The character data type is used to store character data into variable in the database. The character data type again subdivided into some other subtypes. The first subtype is character length or character length. The character length or char length data type, which is used to store character into particular variable. The syntax is char into bracket size semicolon. The size means number of characters which are stored in particular variable. The example is character I into bracket n. Here n means the length or size of character or string which are stored in variable I. The if we have we does not give particular size or particular length in data type declaration, then the by default value which is given by that particular data type is 1, and the maximum data which are stored in particular data type is 2000 byte. That means 16000 character maximum stored in particular data type while we store data type character. Here is the example of data type char or character, that how we store character data into database. Next, the next subtype of character data type is varchar2 size. The varchar2 data type also accept character or string data into particular data type. The syntax is varchar2 size semicolon. Here also size means number of characters which are stored in particular data type or particular variable. If we does not give any size to store that character data, then by default size is 1 to store that data into that data type. And the maximum length of storing data into that variable is 4000 byte. That means 32000 characters are maximum stored in that particular data type or that particular variable. These are the different example in which we give the data type name varchar2 after that variable and after that I, that means size semicolon. Here varchar2 10, that means the 10 characters are stored in the variable I. The cells or cells 10, that means cells are the particular variable name, and in that cells we store 10 length data into that variable. The next character data type is n varchar2 size. The n varchar2 data type also accept character or string. The variable length of character n varchar2 data is maximum length, that is n character of length or n character of byte, depending on the national character set. The syntax is n varchar2 size. Here also size means number of character or string stored in that particular variable. The example is n varchar2 I into bracket n. N represent the number of length or length of that particular character or string. Here also the maximum number of character stored 4000 bytes in that particular variable. The n varchar2 10 is the example of that particular n varchar2 data type. The next data type is NCHAR site. The NCHAR data type also used to access or to input character or string into that variable. The syntax is NCHAR size and the example is NCHAR into bracket N semicolon. Here N means size of that data or limitation of particular data to store in that variable. The maximum data here stored 2000 bytes, and these are the example same as the character or NCHAR or CHAR 2. The example we store NCHAR data. The next is numeric data type. How we store numeric data type by using SQL data type. The numeric data type is used to store the numerical value or integer value in the variable while storing our data into relational database management system. The numeric data type also divided into again different subtypes. The first subtype is number into bracket P comma S. The number data type is used to store number number into variable. The syntax is number into bracket P comma S semicolon. Here P means precision. Precision means the length of number in particular digit, and the S means scales, which places or which gives the decimal point into that particular numerical value. For example, here number I into bracket 3 comma 1 semicolon. That means our data stored in the variable I having 3 digit length, and it gives or it places decimal point after last digit is completed. Here we represent n means n number of character or n number of integer number. Here is the second example. This is the numeric value of 9 digit long. There are different format of giving numeric or number data type. The first example is number into bracket 9 semicolon. It means it stores 9 digit number of number data type. The second example is number I into bracket 9 comma 1. It stores 9 digit number into I variable and places the scale or places decimal point after last digit. Then the third example is number I 9 comma 2. This also example of placement of decimal point. Here we store the ninth digit number into I variable and we place the last two digit the decimal point. Therefore the 7456123.89 type value are stored in this third number of example. The last example is number asterisk 3 semicolon. It means we store any long number of digit and we place the decimal point after last three numbers are completed. Therefore here we store example 7456.123. After last three digit completed, we give the decimal point in this example. Thus in the next, the numeric data type is the integer or int. It also used to store numeric data type like whole numbers or integer number. The syntax is integer or int. The integer number access or integer data type access only integer value or only whole numbers. That does not accept any fractional point or any decimal number. The example is int I into bracket n. Here n represent the number of integer number. The example is int I 9. That means 9 number of digit or 9 number of long digit value is stored in I variable of having integer or whole number data type. The next numeric data type is decimal. The decimal number is accept the decimal point or fractional number into our database. The syntax is decimal p comma s or tec p comma s. Here the precision is the positive integer that indicates number of digit that the particular value contain. Decimal data type is declared following syntax: decimal semicolon or decimal into bracket p. It accept only precision number, and decimal p comma s it accept with the precision number and scales also. The decimal number access fractional number or any decimal value. It stores particular fractional number with its decimal point or its scale. The example is decimal number comma 9, decimal 9 comma 3. Here we have given the decimal point after completion of last three digit. Then here the point, the value is stored 7455678 93. Thus we store decimal number in our database by using decimal data type. The next numeric data type is float. This also used to store decimal number or floating number into our variable. This is same syntax as for decimal point. Here instead of decimal, here we give the keyword float. The example is float 6,2. Therefore here we store data having length 6 number of digit, and we give the scale point or decimal point after last two digit is completed, and that data stored which is the floating point or which is decimal point. The next data type is double. The double data type is the long number of integers which are stored in particular variable. The length of particular data is up to 64 digits. That means 64 digits are stored in particular variable. These are the example of storing long number of data into our double data type. Next. This the third main data type is the date. The date data type which are given for storing or accessing date or current system date into our relational database management system. The date is stored in the format of 4y minus 2m minus double d. That means year, month and day type of format. The syntax is the keyword have given date. Here the example of date data type is date and system current date semicolon. We have also given the date data type likewise date into single quotation your current system date and semicolon. Thus the current date is stored by using our current date is retrieved by using date data type in the relational database management system. The next data type is time. The time data type is used to display or to store current time or current system date. Here the time is in the format of hours, minutes and seconds. The format of time data type stored is HH, MM and SS. HH means hours, MM means minutes and SS means seconds. The time data type is declared like example as shown in the slide. Time into single quotation your current system time, single quotation complete and semicolon. Thus by using time data type we store and access time in our relational database. The last particular data type is the timestamp. The timestamp data type is used combinedly displaying or combinedly inserting your current system date and your current system time. Example or syntax of timestamp data type is timestamp, and into single quotation you have given current system date and current system time. Thus, by next, thus in this lecture we have seen the different types of SQL data types. There are five main different data types, that is character, numeric, date, time and timestamp. These main data types again subdivided into sub types, that is character data type subdivided into char, varchar 2, n varchar 2 and n char. The numeric data type, which is stored numeric data, again subdivided into number, int, decimal, float and double. The date is divided into date to store current system date or to display back date, that is birth date or joint date in particular organization. The time data type is used to display or to insert current system time or back time of any situation. And the last data type is timestamp. This timestamp is used to insert or to display both date and time, that may be current system date or current system time or back any other object date and time. Thus, in this today's lecture, we are completed the different data types which are used in SQL. In next lecture, we see the next point in relational database management system. I hope all of you understand the different data types in SQL, how we store different type of data into variable by using these different data types in relational database management system through SQL data types. Thank you.